Faisal Khaq est du Liban et il va nous faire part de l'état des lieux dans la région arabe qu'il connaît très bien. Faisal, à toi la parole.
شكرا دكتور خالد وشكرا كمان للجمعية التونسية وصباح الخير و thank you for being here everyone. كمان صباح الخير for my colleagues and the moderators. بس حدا يقول لي كيف. اوكي. I will present on the context of cancer in the Arab world and the cervical cancer within the context and the burden of cervical cancer and how it is different from a country to a country and what are the possible implementation strategy that works for the Arab region. So يعني أول شيء we all know that the public health system and the health system in the MENA region, the Middle East, North Africa, is in general a very poor system with a poor infrastructure. When we say poor, يعني ده له علاقة بالnational screening, okay, له علاقة بالnational guidelines for treatment. And remember, cervical cancer elimination is one of the strategies of the OMS for the 2030. OMS, في five strategies. واحدة منهم هي elimination of cervical cancer. This public health weakness, it was obvious during COVID-19. During the COVID-19 pandemic, the public health system was very poor in this region. The OMS identified six trajectories of cancer, okay? Six trajectories that will increase cancer incidence and prevalence globally. Tobacco, physical inactivity, infection, HPV, environmental pollution, occupational carcinogen, and radiation. وكل هدول الست strategies are very much present in low middle income countries اللي هو المينا region تقريبا الماجوريتي تبعه is a low middle income countries. إذا طلعنا على ال profile of cancer in the East Mediterranean region we will see this is the blue is the incidence of cancer in the whole region. The red is the mortality. You can see for example Qatar, Emirates, Lebanon is leading, while, for example, Tunis is in the middle of cancer in general. Okay, so Tunis is doing well in terms of incidence and mortality, while other countries are much bigger. In fact, Tunis is one of the least countries in terms of incidence and mortality. And if you look at all the countries, this is from the Lancet, you can see that the red one is the breast cancer, is the leading cancer in the whole region, in the whole Arab region. Okay? Ovarian cancer, which is in yellow, okay, is like number two or number three in the region. Sometimes it comes after breast, sometimes it comes number three, which is a serious cancer. These are the cancers present in the most of the Arab region. Number one is breast, number two colorectal, and number three is cancer of the cervix. Mishanek, it's very important to make a national strategy and a national screening system to deal with this one. In 2018, Kanfi from the Tunis Center of Public Health, min Tunis, we have numbers لكل العالم العربي. كان في تقريبا 15,000 new cases. كان في تقريبا 9,500 death in 1 year from cervical cancer. This is where the Arab world is. Okay, the Arab region is dark green all the way to light green. little bit lower than the other countries. Okay. هلا المشرق العربي the dark green يعني Egypt, the Gulf, Lebanon, Syria, Jordan, they have more incidence of cervical cancer and more mortality أكثر من المغرب العربي. في المغرب العربي يعني موروك is much higher. موروك في مشكل أكثر من الجزائر وأكثر من تونس. This is by age standard. By age standard على كل 100,000 women تقريبا في العالم العربي في تقريبا بين 2 و5 وفيات cervical cancer على 100,000 which is in the middle. بس ولكن الكانسر ريتس عم بيزيدوا بالعالم العربي أسرع من غير من different countries. That's why there was this meeting in Dubai accelerating action on HPV and cervical cancer because of the growing number of deaths among women in the Arab region. This is from the EMRO. بيقول إنه كمان السرطان عنق الرحم في المرتبة 13 في كل السرطانات في العالم العربي ولكن تقريبا عموما بالمرتبة الخامسة عند النساء. أحيانا بيجي رقم 2 بعد البريست أحيانا بيجي رقم 3 ولكن always in the top 5 for female cancer. إذا اطلعنا على ال burden, this is a recent paper of cervical cancer on the East Mediterranean, حنشوف absolute number of death. Okay, absolute number of death due to cervical cancer increased from 2000 to the year 2017. يعني خلال ال 17 سنة اللي فاتت صار في ارتفاع قوي بالسيرفيكال كانسر كمعدلات ولكن الوفيات انخفضت او لانه عم نعمل early screening او عم نعمل early treatment ولكن المعدلات بعدها مرتفعة. المعدلات المرتفعة هنشوف بعدين معناته انه we are not reaching every woman for screening ولكن المورتاليتي اقل لانه العمل those that are diagnosed are being treated well. طبعا في فوارق كتير بين البلاد العربية. This is a statement from the WHO. If no action is taken, يعني إذا ما صار في screening national, okay, by 2040 حيكون عندنا 15,000 deaths per year. وهذا death ما إله عازة. It's useless. يعني حرام المرأة تموت من cervical cancer. How the 15 lost lives of women, 15,000. الموضوع الثاني بدي أحكي عنه هو إنه ال cervical cancer, الموت من ال cervical cancer ما بيشبه بعضه بكل البلاد العربية. إذا بتطلع على ال لون الفيولي هو يعني the good ranking of death rate per 100,000. بنشوف عنا ال يعني الأرقام مثل ما قلت بالإيست أراب ريجن عم بتكون أعلى من الأرقام تبع الوست ريجن. يعني حتى داخل كل بلد نسب الوفيات تختلف. هون إذا منشوف المورتاليتي بالبلو والإنسيدنس هيدي من المغرب العربي أيضا تونس ومصر عم بيكونوا أقل مقارنة مع ليبيا والجزائر والسودان بالنسبة للاثنين المورتاليتي والإنسيدنس. إذا متطلع على البلاد المشرق العربي حيكون جوردن والسعودية أقل بينما لبنان قطر والخليج أعلى بكتير. شو هي الميزات للسيرفيكال كانسر بكل بلد؟ يعني هل تختلف الباثولوجي او الباثولوجي تبع السيرفيكال كانسر من بلد لبلد؟ هيدا اذا بدكم الرانكينج اوف سيرفيكال كانسر انسيدنس باي ايج. اذا بنطلع على العالم العربي الانسيدنس باي ايج اول ايج والإنسيدنس باي ايج ريبرودكتيف ايج يعني من عمر ال 15 لعمر ال 45 هي ذاتها. هذا شيء منيح؟ لا ما منيح. It's not good. Because we are not screening enough. يعني مستحيل يكون الانسيدنس across all age say 75 or 80 years lifespan هي ذات الانسيدنس from 15 to 45. So that's the first thing. The other thing كمان شوف how it is affected by the human development يعني socioeconomic, financial, education. Cervical cancer it will start by the age of 25. Okay, this is the cases per 100,000. بعدين بنشوف كل ما كان ال low index ولو socioeconomic status ولو low education it will be much higher the number of cervical cancer, okay, as compared to the others. يعني
this is where you have a very high income and very high education level, بينما هون عندنا very poor income and very poor education level.
So it's very much related also to the development indicator in every country. Why ليش بعدها خفيفة بتونس أو خفيفة إجمالا في العالم العربي؟ لأنه بنعتقد نحن في ال vulnerability is minimal is low يعني التعرض أقل للملادي سكسوال وأقل أيضا لأنواع ال HPV. وبعدين ال sexual behavior يمكن أقل من بلدان تانية. هون عم نقارن ال HPV. HPV هي the main reason for cervical cancer. HPV is not the same in every Arab country. إذا متطلع على ال على for example ال ال بلدان المغرب العربي في من ال 25 لل 65 عم تنزل ال HPV infection. بينما بغير وبعدين بتصير أقل بال 40s وال 50s. بينما بغير بلاد بتكون very high. شوف مثلا ساوث ايست اسيا او شوف الايسترن حيكون فيري هاي بتوين 20 اند 30. في العالم العربي بين ال 20 وال 30 ال 35 عم بتكون ال اتش بي في اقل بيكوز اوف سيكشوال بيهافير. معناتها انه اذا انت عندك على 25 اتش بي في هاي ريسك 16 او 18 يعني انت متوقع يكون في كانسر اكثر على 35 اور 40 اور 45. لحد هلا نحن لانه السكشوال بيهيفير اقل والاتش بي في اقل عم نشوف انه على الفورتيز والفيفتيز عم بيكون النسبه اقل. ولكن هيدا وي دونت نو وين اتس جوينج تو تشينج. This is a review from the Arab region on the analysis of the HPV prevalence. Okay, the prevalence of HPV in the Arab region is 9.3%. Globally, it's 12%. نحن أقل ولكن we are close to the global. The most frequent HPV types, HPV 16, 2.3%, 18.7%, HPV 6, اللي بيعمل wart, 0.7%, 11.6%, and 31%. هو 0.5%. So the high risk هن 16, 18 وال 31 عنا تقريبا between 0.5% and 2.5%. ولكن أيضا I think بهيدا البيبر في داتا إنه حتى 6-11 اللي هن بيعملوا genital warts on pap smear تبين فيه precancerous changes. ويعني انه في العالم العربي ممكن ال 6-11 عم تعمل precancerous changes on pap smear مثل الاسكس وحتى عم بتأرجينا سين 1 وعم بتأرجينا LSIL. So something to keep in mind لما بنقرا الباب سمير وبنعمل reporting عليها. هذه البيبر from the Gulf region من الخليج. الخليج في international communities people coming from everywhere بتشوف انه ال 21% is the positive HPV 21% which is very high. وبالهاي ريسك كان ال non 16 non 18 هو اعلى شيء 63%. يعني ما كان 16-18 هو 17% و 3% non-HPV يعني non-higher, non-16-18 يعني 45-33-31-58 كانوا تقريبا 63% it's very high كان أكثر عند non-Arab women من Arab women اللي عملوا دراسة بدبي بالخليج كان قطر number one 31.3% HPV high risk positive بحرين 20% سعودي 70% والإمارات 15% my last part is about the possible screening strategies for the Arab region this is the WHO strategy I'm sure Dr. Ibrahim will mention something about this which is the 90-70-90 حتحكي عنها دكتور إبراهيم okay so ما حكي عنها أنا But this is the gold standard strategy for cervical cancer elimination by OMS. Okay, 90-70-90. This is from the FIGO cervical cancer also eliminating project. FIGO is playing a major role also in cancer elimination and also sponsoring 5 projects in Bangladesh, in India, Colombia, and Nepal for cervical cancer elimination. So here, ورشة كبيرة globally عم بتصير this is the strategies also available on the OMS website this is a very interesting paper by Ortaş from the cervical cancer screening in the Arab countries what do we have for screening you have organized screening high cost ولكن high coverage and very effective you have opportunistic screening يعني اليوم واحدة تمروا واحدة بعد جمعة اثنين ثلاثة اوكي random it doesn't help low cost ولكن low coverage of the population and you don't do anything you sit in the clinic and people come to you and do a pap smear HPV vaccination it's a high coverage for the population and it is very effective so او بنعمل pap smear فروتي او HPV vaccination أو screening plus HPV vaccination which is the best It's very high coverage okay and very high effective or you do the visual inspection with acetic acid this is how the countries vary in terms of their risk and what to use for screening okay so the risk of cervical cancer in every country should tell the government and should tell the society and the policy what exactly do we do. See?
This is, if a woman is in Libya, this is her risk. 1.8. If she is living in Saudi Arabia, 0.28.
Okay? So you have to, if she's in Tunis, 0.34. طيب. هتعمل ايه في تونس؟ سيرفيك بتعمل باب سمير or HPV, or you do the combination of both. So it's important to go at the risk of cervical cancer incidence across life. The other thing, which is really wrong, is that women, they don't want to do a pap smear. Women, they don't want to go to the doctor. It's not true. Women, they don't know exactly the risk of cervical cancer. And these are different studies from the Arab region. Telling us that women are willing to do a pap smear if they know the relation between HPV and pap smear. We don't. Because you always relate HPV and cervical cancer to sexual activity. And when you say sexual activity, people start like, أنا ماليش علاقة في السكس, ماليش علاقة في sexual activity. It is a vaccination, it is a screening for cervical cancer, not for sexual infections. ما الليفر كانسر هو كمان ليفر كانسر هيباتيتس بي لما بيخلق البيبي بنعمل هيباتيتس بي شو عم نعمل تيست فور سيرفي فور سيكشوال اكتيفيتي هيباتيتس بي از ا سيكشوال اكتيفيتي از ا سيكشوال انفكشن بيعمل ليفر كانسر سو وي شود ساي ات از ا سكرينينج فور سيرفيكال كانسر ويتش از ا توب كانسر افتر بريست فور فيميل اوكي بيكوز ذا اكسبتابيليتي اوف ذا فاكسينيشن by the Arab woman is very much similar to the global acceptability. المرأة العربية بتقبل الـ HPV vaccine بتقول لك نعم I want، مثل ما الأمريكية والأوروبية والآسيوية بتقول أنا بدي كمان. We're not different. But we don't know enough. These are two papers from the region. 12% knew that there was HPV vaccine. فقط 13% من النساء بيعرفوا أنه في HPV vaccine. ما حدا خبرهم. لأنه الطبيب أو النظام الصحي بيفترض أنه المرأة ما بدها. أو منا sexual active. أو منا concerned with cervical cancer. مش مزبوط. It's not true. If you tell them, they will do it. 80% did not know that HPV is sexually transmitted, and 70% heard about HPV vaccine فقط. And only 2% took it because of lack of advocacy and lack of education. This is a paper we did from Lebanon. It will show that those that live in the city that will have high income, high education, married with health coverage, they will do the pap smear and take the vaccine. And this is where you can start thinking at the policy level. If you are a high resource country, then you integrate the HPV vaccination program and organized cervical cancer. يعني الهاي ريسك الميديوم اند هاي انكم كونتري، يمكن ميديوم زي تونس زي لبنان الغلف، they should do integrated pap smear screening and HPV vaccination. In the low income countries يعني في ترايل صارت بالسودان شاف انه ال VIA visual inspection can be really of help. This is a paper we published last week also from Lebanon, me and my friends. Also it showed that it is very possible to do a national screening with pap smear. We did this study on 14,000 and it showed that we can really generate good information for national screening. My last slide would be, what does it take for the Arab region to do a national screening? A solid national screening is a political will, okay? Define the vaccine as a cancer vaccine, not a sexual infection vaccine. Khalid, يعني كمان the provider, the gynecologist, play an important role in telling the woman, every woman in the clinic and outside, keep the media, okay? Do a public campaign, start with the schools, and also take care of those that are fighting the vaccine. يعني طلع الفاكسين تبع كوفيد 19 everybody was like هيدي مؤامرة ولا يجوز نفس الشيء بكرة HPV فاكسين بيقول لك لا يجوز وهيدي تخرب العيال وتخرب الناس وتخرب كذا إلى آخره. Thank you very much. This is from Phagos. This is the most preventable disease يا جماعة. Remember, no woman should die of cervical cancer. Thank you very much.